हेलो व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल दास अकाडमी ऑफ साइंस। इन दिस वीडियो यू लर्न अबाउट स्ट्रक्चर एंड पार्ट्स ऑफ द ह्यूमन आई, फंक्शन ऑफ वेरियस पार्ट्स इन ह्यूमन आई, अकोमोडेशन ऑफ द आई लेंस, मैक्सिमम एंड मिनिमम फोकल लेंस ऑफ द आई लेंस। ह्यूमन आई। The human eye is one of the most important sense organs. It enables us to see the objects and colors around us. Let us discuss about structure and parts of human eye. The eyeball is nearly spherical in shape. The front portion is more sharply curved and is covered by a transparent protective membrane called the cornea. It is the portion which is visible from outside. Behind the cornea, there is a place filled with a liquid called aqueous humor. And behind this, there is a crystalline lens which is responsible for the image formation. Between the aqueous humor and lens, there is a muscular diaphragm called iris, which has a small hole in it is called pupil. Iris is the colored part that we see in an eye. The light that enters through the pupil into the eye lens and forms an image on the retina. Retina covers the rear part of the eyeball. The ciliary muscles to which eye lens is attached helps the eye lens to change its focal length by changing the radius of curvature of the eye lens. When image is formed on retina, the receptors called rods and cones receive the light signals and transmits to the brain through optic nerve fibers. Then the brain interprets these signals and processes the information about the image. Now, let us recall the parts of human eye. Cornea, aqueous humor, lens, iris, pupil, retina, ciliary muscles, and optic nerve. Now let us discuss the function of some important parts of human eye in detail. First, let us know about the function of iris and pupil in human eye. The colored part that we see in the eye is iris, and the small hole in the middle of the iris is pupil. Do you know why pupil appears black? When light falling on pupil, it enters into the eye and there is almost no chance of light coming back to the outside. Hence, pupil appears black in color. Iris helps in controlling the amount of light entering the eye through pupil. When normal condition of light, pupil is in normal size as shown in the figure. In bright or excess light condition, iris makes the pupil contract and thereby prevent the excess light not to enter into the eye. In the case of low light condition, the iris makes the pupil to expand so that more light is allowed to go. Thus, iris enables pupil to act as a variable aperture for entry of the light into the eye. Now let us discuss about lens and retina. This is lens and this is retina. Eye lens is hard in the middle and gradually becomes soft towards the outer edge. The light that enters the eye lens forms an image on the retina. Since the eye lens is convex, it forms real and inverted image on retina. The retina is a delicate membrane which contains about 125 million receptors called rods and cones. Rods identify the intensity of light, cones identify the color of light. These rods and cones receives the light signals, and these signals are transmitted to the brain through about 1 million of optic nerve fibers. The brain interprets these signals and finally processes the information so that we perceive the object in terms of its shape, size, and color. The interesting thing is that in a normal healthy person, the distance between eye lens and retina is about 2.5 centimeters. That is, the image distance is about 2.5 centimeters only. That is, for any position of the object in front of the eye, whether it is at infinite distance or at least distance of distinct vision or between infinity and least distance of distinct vision, the image distance is fixed and it is about 2.5 centimeters. How can we get this same image distance for various positions of objects? This is possible only when eye lens can change its focal length. How does eye lens change its focal length? This can be possible only when the eye lens is able to change its shape, that is, it should be change its radii of curvature. Which part of eye helps the eye lens to change its focal length? That is, ciliary muscles. Now, let us discuss about the function of ciliary muscles in eye. The ciliary muscles to which eye lens is attached helps the eye lens to change its focal length by changing the radii of curvature of the eye lens. When the eye is focused on a distant object, the ciliary muscles are relaxed so that the focal length of eye lens has its maximum value, which is equal to its distance from the retina. The parallel rays coming into the eye are then focused on the retina and we see the object clearly. When the eye is focused on a closer object, the ciliary muscles are strained and focal length of eye lens is decreased. The ciliary muscles adjust the focal length in such a way that the image is formed on retina and we see the object clearly. This processing of adjusting the focal length is called accommodation. However, these muscles cannot strain beyond a limit. You know that eye lens itself changes its focal length in accordance with the distance of the object with the help of ciliary muscles. Is there any limit to change the focal length of eye lens? What are the maximum and minimum focal lengths of the eye lens? Let us find. When the object is at infinity, the parallel rays from the object falling on the eye lens are refracted and they form a point-sized image on the retina. In this situation, eye lens has a maximum focal length. To find maximum focal length of eye lens, we need object distance and image distance. Object distance is the distance between object and lens. Here, object is at infinity distance, the object distance is infinity, but according to sign convention, it is taken as minus infinity. And the image distance is nothing but distance between lens and image. Since the distance between eye lens and retina is 2.5 centimeters and image formed on the retina, image distance is taken as 2.5 centimeters. So, u is minus infinity and v is 2.5 centimeters. Let us find the maximum focal length of eye lens. By lens formula we have 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. Here, object distance u is minus infinity and image distance v is 2.5 centimeters. Substituting u and v values in the above equation, we get 1 by f maximum is equal to 1 by 2.5 minus 1 by minus infinity. That is, 1 by f maximum is equal to 1 by 2.5 plus 0. Why? Because 1 by infinity is 0, minus of 1 by minus infinity is plus 0. So, 1 by f maximum equal to 1 by 2.5. That is, f maximum is equal to 2.5 centimeters. That is, maximum focal length of eye lens is 2.5 centimeters. Consider that an object is placed at a distance of 25 centimeters from our eye. Why? Because 25 centimeters is nothing but least distance of distinct vision of a healthy person. When the object is at least distance of distinct vision, the rays from the object falling on the eye lens are refracted and they form a point-sized image on the retina. In this situation, the eye lens has minimum focal length. To find minimum focal length of eye lens, we need object distance and image distance. You know very well, object distance is nothing but the distance between object and lens, and image distance is nothing but distance between lens and image. Here, the object distance is taken as 25 centimeters because object is kept at the distance of least distance of distinct vision, and image distance is 2.5 centimeters since the distance between eye lens and retina is 2.5 centimeters only. Let us find minimum focal length of eye lens. By lens formula we have 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. Here u is 25 centimeters, but according to sign convention it is taken as minus 25 centimeters, and v image distance is 2.5 centimeters. Substituting the u and v values in the above equation, we get 1 by f minimum is equal to 1 by 2.5 minus 1 by minus 25. That is 1 by f minimum equal to 1 by 2.5 minus of minus it is plus, so that it is plus 1 by 25. Now 1 by f minimum equal to 11 by 25. Why? Because 1 by 2.5 is nothing but 10 by 25. In total it is 10 by 25 plus 1 by 25, that is 11 by 25. That is f minimum equal to 25 by 11. So f minimum is equal to 2.27 centimeters. That is minimum focal length of eye lens is 2.27 centimeters. So when the object is at infinity, maximum focal length of eye lens is 2.5 centimeters, and when object is at the least distance of distinct vision, minimum focal length of eye lens is 2.27 centimeters. If the position of the object is between infinity and the point of least distance of distinct vision, then the eye lens adjusts its focal length in between 2.5 centimeters to 2.27 centimeters to form a clear image on the retina. The ability of eye lens to change its focal length is called accommodation of lens. If the eye lens is not able to adjust its focal length, or if the focal length of eye lens is beyond the range of 2.5 centimeters to 2.27 centimeters, the person cannot see the objects clearly and comfortably. That is, the vision becomes blurred due to accommodation defects of the eye lens. Thank you. If you like this video, please share and subscribe my channel, Das Academy of Science.